E ta ia le paia maulunga wa fiom papa ao. Le paia le popo malmamalua o'o. Wa sa moa matangata Pasifika wa whangapotpoto. I want to thank the chair and the trustees of the Pacific Music Awards for your wonderful work and for the invitation to speak tonight. I acknowledge the presence of our beautiful and gifted artists and nominees. I also thank my ministerial colleague, the Honourable Carmel Cipollone, who's here with me tonight. I want to acknowledge we have a special guest, Iloa Fionga, the Deputy Prime Minister of Samoa, Iloa Fionga Fiumea Naomi. I also want to acknowledge our Pacific councillors, members of the local board of Auckland Council. Iloa Fionga Faultoi Rupinapongi, Consul General of Samoa, Mrs. Rosie Blake, the Consul General of Cook Islands, our church leaders, our traditional leaders, our chiefs and orators, our business leaders, our public sector leaders, our youth leaders, and to our generous sponsors whose loyalty and commitment has sustained these awards so many years, for so many years now. Families, friends and supporters, warm Pacific greetings to you all. Welcome to the 2008 Pacific Music Arts Award. My elders have often said, "Ele falala fuala wala'au." The trees of the forest do not move without reason. E mafua on falala on na wangi na matangi. They move because the winds have begun to blow. Tonight, I feel the winds of change in the air. We're all here to celebrate and acknowledge your artistic successes, there is no doubt. But it's also a time to reflect on our past and to gain inspiration from it as we look to the future. The Pacific Music Awards were set up to realize a vision for the celebration of Pacific music. We're realizing that vision here tonight. It's now an iconic event, a highlight of the New Zealand music industry calendar. I never once doubted that it would be. Our people are just naturally gifted when it comes to music and the arts. I recall back in 2005, when Reverend Mua, Sina and Petrina came to seek help from the former Manukau City Council to sponsor and support a new initiative called the Pacific Music Awards. I didn't need to be convinced about supporting it. We just had to work out how would we get the funding from Manukau City Council and to keep the Pacific Music Awards in the South Side. Well, we did it. And it's probably one of the best investment the Manukau City Council ever made. The awards moved here in 2006, and I'm so pleased that we continue to celebrate it in South Side Auckland. There are so many people who shared, you can clap. From Mangere. There are so many people who shared our vision back then and laid the foundations for this magnificent achievement. They include, of course, the trustees of the Pacific Music Awards, the many wonderful public, private, and industry sponsors, and all of you, the musicians, your families, and the wider Pacific community here in Aotearoa, New Zealand, and throughout the Pacific region. I knew then the Pacific Music Awards would someday become a recognized iconic feature of the international music scene. I believed it then and I believe it now. Every year since 2005, the lineup of fantastic Pacifica talent has continued to grow and grow and grow. Philip Fuemana, Cas Futialo, The Fieldstyle, At Ease, Arija, Dayhamo, Bill Sevesi, Savage, Aratna, Chongni, The Yandel Sisters, Tevaka, Scribe, Three Houses Down, Lady Six, Devolo, Nijin Mystic, Tingi Lau Ness, Annie Crummer, Vanya Toloa, Mavis Rivers, Sole Mio, King Kapisi, Shefu, Herbs, Brooke Fraser, Annie Grace, Vince Harder, Pacific Underground, Opetaya Fuai, Brother Love, Kings, Punya Lava'a, and one of the youngest, General Fire. And that's only naming a few, and there are so many, many more of our gifted artists that have been recognized over the years by the Pacific Music Awards. Your successes as Pacific artists was not just based on your own genius, but also on our recognition of the power and potential of our music our languages, our customs, and your ancestral heritage. So where to now? Where do we need to go now? Is this it? Is this all we're capable of achieving? I say resoundingly no. We can and must achieve more. The Pacific Music Award is an asset, a Pacific and a national asset in the new Aotearoa New Zealand, and that is now emerging around us. What we need to do now is to protect and develop that asset and increase its value and contribution to Aotearoa New Zealand. I'd like to see the Pacific Music Awards Trust open up to the community and see how it can better capture and serve the talent we see here tonight. Now, please don't take that as a criticism. That's not what I'm saying. Let me be clear. I'm saying we need to take things to the next level, a higher level. I'd like to see the Pacific Music Award Trust operate as a body that not only celebrates Pacific talent, but also protects, develops, and grows our musical talent, our knowledge of the industry, and our influence. Why is it that we have so much talent, but still so many of you who aren't able to make a living from your music? Is that just the nature of the business, or is there another way? Why is it that we have so much original content and your music gets played on the airwaves, but you're not earning any royalties? How can we get APRA to help us in this space? Surely we have a unique point of difference based on our language, culture, and Pacificness, or Nisian identity that we should be promoting and growing. Surely we can do more. These are questions I'd like the Trust and our sponsors to take on board. As we look to the future, let me say this. A people is defined by its language and culture. It's what makes us who we are, our ways of perceiving the world and ourselves. Our culture is our identity. If we lose those elements, we lose our uniqueness and become just like everybody else. Why should we want to become like everybody else? Our ancestors navigated their way through the vast oceans in canoes made from natural materials. They took with them their cultural traditions, their language, their spirituality, and taro. They were guided by reading the currents and swells of the ocean waters, the flight paths of birds, reading the stars, and knowing the exact spot where the sun would rise and set. They relied heavily on constant observation and memorization, constantly being aware of their surroundings. They did not have watches, compasses, iPhones, or speedometers, but they had their minds and the ability to memorize their surroundings. And with constant observation, they reach their new destinations. We must do the same with taking our Pacific music into the future, to the next level, to a higher level. When the European explorers arrived years later to the Pacific region, they were surprised to see the Pacific Islands were already populated, didn't need to be discovered. Let us surprise the whole world again with our Pacific music by being bold, innovative, and being really successful at it. We must continue to be brave and navigate our Pacific artists through the digital divide. We must counterbalance the contemporary artistry with our unique indigenous cultures. I'd like to see the Pacific Music Awards working across government and business to ensure that our talented young people get their just commercial reward, that we as Pacific communities benefit from the surging talent that defines us. I'd like to see the Pacific Music Awards Trust help ensure that our artists benefit from the businesses that their talents generate, that they receive their fair share of our profits, that those profits come home and don't just evaporate overseas, that our communities benefit from the business investment our arts and music generate. You've all heard of Sir Peter Jackson. You've all heard of Wellywood. Well, I'd like to see a commercial music hub just like that developed right here for our Pacific musicians. I believe we can do it. This is our asset. We can build a music industry that, while global in its reach, firmly rooted in its Pacific home and identity, an industry that generates employment and wealth for our Pacific artists. I want to challenge the Pacific Music Arts Awards Trust to do more. And as they do so, I can assure you, and I make this promise, I will do all in my power to support and encourage them in their work. The future is what we make of it, and the prospects are golden. Pasifika people are the future of Aotearoa New Zealand. Let's make it happen. Kia kaha, whaftai mai amanuia.